Welcome to Antenna and Wave Propagation playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain helical antenna. So here, outlines of this session, that is basics of helical antenna, properties of helical antenna, structure of helical antenna, then I'll explain modes of operation which is there with helical antenna. Then we'll see how radiation that is happening with helical antenna. And then we'll discuss few applications which is there with helical antenna. So these are my session outlines for this session based on helical antenna. So let us begin this session with first outline, that is basics and properties of helical antenna. So first of all, what is helical antenna? Helical antenna is just a conductor wound in helical shape and that is fed with respect to ground. So helical antenna, that is just a conductor wound in a helical shape. Like see, for example, if I say I have this cylinder and over which if I wound wire, in that case it will make it to helical shape. So that is what helical antenna, where we feed it with respect to ground. It has this basic properties, like it could be having broadband characteristics. If you design it properly, we can have broadband characteristics by having helical antenna, and it can provide circular polarization. So these two are very important properties which is there with helical antenna. It has broadband characteristics, it can provide circular polarization. So this is what the basic characteristics which is there with helical antenna. Now let us move on to next point, that is structure of helical antenna. So one can see this is what helix, that is what we are connecting it to this feed, where this is what coaxial cable, where inner conductor that is connected to this helix and outer conductor that is connected to ground. So this is inner conductor that is connected to this helical antenna, and this is outer conductor that is what we are connecting it to ground. This is what ground plane. Now when we design this helical antenna, few basic things that we need to focus about. One is, what is the diameter of this helix? So this is what diameter of helix. This is spacing between two turns. S is spacing between two turns. And from diameter, we can calculate circumference. And circumference, that is equals to pi d. So pi into d, that is circumference. Now, S is spacing in between them. And length L0, that is what? A length of one turn. So here S is spacing in between two turns. D is diameter of helix. C is circumference, that is what? Diameter into pi. L0, that is what? Length of one turn. So by having these elements, S, D, circumference and length L0, one can design helical antenna. Now here, see this angle is alpha, and obviously as I have told, length is L0 for one turn and spacing is S in between two turns. So circumference, that is what having this side, spacing S that is having this side. So diagonal, that will be L0. So as per Pythagoras theorem, L0 can be calculated from circumference as well as spacing. And that we can calculate by L0 is equals to square root of S square plus C square. So that is how we can calculate L0. And we can even calculate alpha. Then that alpha, we can say tan alpha. So that we can calculate as per opposite by adjacent. So it will be S by C, where S is spacing in between two elements and C is circumference of helical antenna. Now here what will happen with respect to alpha, that is what I'll be discussing first. If I say alpha is equals to 0, let us consider few cases. So if alpha is equals to 0, if alpha is equals to 0 means this L0 is equals to C, it means spacing will become 0. So if alpha is equals to 0, this spacing will be 0. It means all the turns that will be there on each other. It means this will be loop antenna. So if alpha is equals to 0, spacing between these turns that will be 0. And as if spacing between elements is 0, this antenna will be multi number of loop antenna. So multi turn loop antenna, that will happen in case of alpha is equals to 0. So this antenna is loop antenna in that case. Now next case, that is if alpha is equals to 90. Now see, if alpha is equals to 90 like this, so in that case spacing between turn is infinite. This spacing between two turn, that will get to infinite. So it means this will become straight wire. If alpha is equals to 90, in that case spacing will become infinite. Just make it to 90 like this. So if it is 90, so in that case this spacing will become infinite. And if this spacing becomes infinite, this will be simple straight wire and it will make it to monopole antenna. So if alpha is equals to 90, this antenna is linear antenna. And if alpha that is there in between 0 to 90 means there will be certain amount of spacing, then it will be helical antenna. Then one can say this antenna is helical antenna. So that is what the importance which is there for alpha. So see here, L0 that we can calculate as per square root of S square plus C square, and tan alpha, that is what, spacing divided by circumference. And based on value of alpha, this shape of wire could result into different types of antennas. Like if alpha is 0, this will become loop antenna. If alpha is 90, this will become monopole antenna, linear antenna. And if it is in between 0 to 90, this antenna will be helical antenna, as you can see it in this figure. So let us move on to next point, that is different types of ground plane in helical antenna. So here one can clearly see there are three different types of ground plane. One is plane ground plane, second is curved ground plane, and third is deep conical ground plane. So now what is the importance of this shape of ground plane? So one basic importance of these shapes, that is it provides mechanical safety to this helix. So one basic advantage that one can easily say, it provides mechanical safety to this helical antenna. Like see here, we are providing feeding, and if this is what curved over here, then this helical shape will not damage from the feeding point. So it gives some mechanical stability over here, right? In this case even, one can have mechanical safety. And one more thing, that is what it providing, like radiation which is happening in back direction, that could be reduced. Like see, for example, if I say radiation which happens by this plane helix, that is like this, right? So in this case, radiation is in this direction like this. But if you have this shape of ground plane, in that case, now radiation pattern, if you see that radiation pattern, then now that will be having lower minor lobes. So other than major lobe, minor lobe will decrease with its magnitude. So in this case, even one can observe minor lobe magnitude that is getting decreased by this shape of ground plane. Now one thing that one should remember when they design helical antenna for ground, then here we have ground with a diameter D. Here we have ground with a diameter D. Now this diameter of ground, that should be greater than 3 lambda by 4. So that should, this is what we need to remember to have a proper radiation characteristic. This diameter, that should be greater than 3 lambda by 4. It should be like this. Otherwise what happens is like minor lobes will increase. So to suppress minor lobe, we should have infinite ground plane. Right, but that is not possible. But this is what we should provide to get proper radiation characteristic. So for plane ground plane of helix, we should provide diameter that should be greater than 3 lambda by 4 to get proper radiation characteristic. So there are different types of ground plane which is there with helical antenna: plane ground plane, curved ground plane, and deep conical ground plane. And this two different types of ground plane has two advantages. One is it provides mechanical safety to helical antenna. And second is, it is reducing minor lobes magnitude in radiation characteristics. So minor lobe magnitude is decreasing as per this ground plane is providing even safety, and it decreases minor lobes magnitude. So these are the advantages for this shape of ground plane. Now let us discuss modes of operation of helical antenna. So basically it operated in two different modes, and this is quite interesting, like how it operated in two different modes. So when we talk about normal mode of operation, radiation characteristics, that is normal to the axis of helix. So in case of normal mode of radiation characteristic, that is normal to the helix. Now see, normal to the helix axis. Now here, this is axis of helical antenna. In both of the cases, I'll explain in parallel, so it will take less time. So this is axis of helix. Now here, in normal mode of operation, radiation that is happening perpendicular to the axis of helix. So radiation pattern that will looks like this. So where nulls are there in the direction of axis of helix. So major radiation that is happening perpendicular to axis of helix. So that is how its radiation characteristic is there. While when we talk about axial mode of helix, in that case major radiation that happens in the direction of helix. So this is what having major lobe radiation, which is in the direction of axis of helix. And obviously minor lobes are always there. Right, over here even there will be minor lobes, but major radiation, that is what we are focusing right now. So in normal mode of operation, major radiation that happens perpendicular to the axis of helix, and in axial mode of operation, major radiation that happens in the direction of axis of helix. Now when we talk about this major radiation of normal mode as well as axial mode. Then how that happens? Then that happens because of, if helix are small compared to the wavelength, if dimension of helix that is smaller than the wavelength, in that case it can have normal mode of helix. Like see, if dimensions is lower than lambda, in that case normal mode of helix is getting operated. And if dimension that is there in between lambda by 3 lambda by 4 to 4 lambda by 3 of circumference, so in that case one can say it will be operated with axial mode. So to get operated with axial mode, C that should be there in between 3 lambda by 4 to 4 lambda by 3. So in that case we can have axial mode of helix operation. And if dimensions are small, in that case it will be having that normal mode of operation. Usually we use helical antenna with axial mode of operation. We don't use this normal mode of operation of helix. Practically applications are available with this axial mode of helical antenna. So let us discuss few applications. It could be utilized in AM broadcast. It is used to null down AC line noise. It is used to decrease TV sweep harmonics. For low frequency applications even we can use it, like RFID, gate parking, in airport security, for door controls. There are so many applications. So this is where we use helical antenna. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, then subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. And you will be finding all those details regarding these videos on my website. So you just go through my website. I have attached link in description of this video. From there you can see my website named engineeringfunda.co.in, where you will be finding all those material which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much and keep sharing with your friends.